Hey guys, what's going on? As you guys saw yesterday, I was really, really emotional because I thought my car, my bread and butter, was gonna be towed away. But God is so good, and God is always seemed like he's right by my side. Wait, I hear a tow truck. I'm paranoid now. I'm about to go out here and make sure she okay. Okay, she good. But I know I just took care of it, so it's like I'm still paranoid about, I don't like stuff like that. And that's why I think it's so easy for me to lose my appetite when I do go through stuff, because I just want things to always be like perfect and, you know, proper and right. And like my dad always used to say, like in life, you know, things are not always going to go straight. You're always going to have some bridge you got to get over, some tunnel you got to go through, something you got to get under. It's always going to be something that you have to deal with, and it's all about your attitude while you're dealing with it. Wow, that was good. But yeah, y'all, so I had to go down to the motor vehicle, take care of a ticket that I thought I already took care of. So now, later on, I think I'm going to go to that courthouse and try to figure out what's going on, because they kind of put me in a jam. I don't know if they're like sending the information to the motor vehicle in time or whatever. And it's like, because I gave them another thing that I got from the DMV telling me that my license was going to be suspended. My registration was going to be suspended again. He looked up the letter, looked up the docket number and everything. He said he didn't even see anything for that in the system. So he told me to call them and try to figure out what's going on. So but as of right now, all my paperwork is straight. The other thing was I didn't put my current car insurance card inside my car. It was like the one that you get when you first sign up for insurance, the temporary one, and then they mail you the permanent one. And I didn't put the permanent. They mailed me the permanent one, and I just left it in an envelope on my dresser. Not on my dresser, but in my little area where I got all of those papers piled up on my table. That's the reason why one of my goals for 2018 was to organize. But now my goal for 2019 was to be consistent. And I don't think I'm doing a good job, y'all. And this was just a little wake-up call to put me back on my, in the right mind of what I need to do. And when I was thinking to myself, like, I need to stay on my right mind. I need to stay on track. I need to stay on task. I looked at my phone and I saw the time 11:11. So that was just confirmation from, you know, my angels, my angel, guardian angels, that yes, stay on task, do the right thing. And because I need to start paying attention to the signs that I be giving, because I be trying to ignore it, but I've been always seeing like numbers for the last, probably about, since I was pregnant with my daughter, I was seeing like the same numbers, I was having dreams, all kinds of stuff started happening, and I think it was just to wake my intuition up a little bit higher, and for me to be more aware and focused on getting, doing better, and like my higher self, trying to reach my higher self. But on another note, y'all know how I get when I don't, when I get into like stressful situations, like what happened over the weekend, me getting pulled over, my car almost being towed, but it didn't get towed. It was just so many emotions. I tend to like lose my appetite a little bit. And with me paying this restoration fee, I'm literally tapped out, y'all. So, you know, I'm literally tapped out. I was thinking about starting a business for women with like, this might sound strange, but women with larger feet, because I tend to notice when I do go shopping for shoes, I don't never see a size as my size, which is size 10 and a half, 11 in women. And you know, that kind of bothers me, because I be wanting cute shoes, not the shoes that I have to just settle for. So I was thinking about doing something like that. And I'm also 5'11", and they make a lot of cute clothes for, to me, shorter frame women, and I have a longer frame. So I wanted to start looking into like getting my LLC and like selling, and maybe get a business ID, like a little boutique or something online boutique. But yeah, because all this paycheck to paycheck stuff is just not kicking it anymore. But on another note, to stay positive, you know, thank God my car wasn't towed away over this weekend. Thank God I had the $100 to pay for my restoration fee. And thank God I have this blueberry bagel. I had some oatmeal this morning. And, you know, I got to make sure I stay fed because stuff like this will have me like, oh my God. Next thing you know, I done lost my appetite. Next thing you know, my gains is not all the way there. Y'all, I had got up to 160. Then I got up to 166, which I don't know if I recorded it or if I'm making a video for that. Because I have stuff in here that I didn't even edit yet or even look at yet. But I'm going to get on the scale right now. Today is March 24th. And I'm about to see how much I weigh. And I'm about to butter my bagel and put some jelly on it so I can get out the door. Because I still got to go to work. Even though I took care of this business, still got to go to work because I took a half a day. So I'm getting ready to butter this bagel, weigh myself, and I'm out the door. And I'll see y'all in a little bit. I'm going to see y'all while I'm weighing myself. All right. Look like I'm 163 right now, y'all. So I'm a little over 160. I'm 163. So I got to keep it going and I got to stay positive. Don't mind that hole in my sock. But yeah, y'all, I got to go. I got to go to work. Hey guys, wait guys, my camera's dirty. Hey guys, what's going on? It's me, just came home, school bell just rang, and I had a crazy, crazy weekend, but I'm still blessed, and I'm still highly favored, and I'm still grateful, and I'm still humble, and I'm still learning lessons in life, you know? I think God is always teaching us lessons in life, no matter how old you are, so you just gotta be paying attention. Like I said, in the last clip, I think I was on my way to motor vehicle. I had to pay a restoration fee for a ticket that I paid, but I didn't pay the ticket on time. I was supposed to pay the ticket by March. What I thought I had to pay the ticket by March 5th. I paid the ticket on March 4th. Motor vehicle said I had to pay the ticket by March 2nd. So in a little bit, I paid the $100 restoration fee. Thank God I even, you know, I had put money up and put money to the side with everything that's going on. I'm just happy that my car didn't get towed away. The cop literally took it down off the tow truck and was like, go take care of that. Grateful that I even had the money to pay the restoration fee. And just happy that it didn't escalate to something bigger. So right now I have a little toothache right here. In my mouth because I had to eat a bagel this morning and it was kind of hard because I toasted it. So, boom, my teeth is acting up. The tooth that I need to get pulled. I'm still waiting for them to, because I went back to the dentist and they put in to approve these two teeth being pulled. They like in the back. I like that. They're like the wisdom. It's like the wisdom tooth and the one that's next to the wisdom tooth back in the back. So, I'm waiting for them to let me know whether I've been approved or not to get them pulled out. Until then, I just gotta wait it out. But I just wanted to let you guys know what was going on with that. And as far as my weight gain journey, I was supposed to weigh myself this morning, so, and I didn't get a chance to do that. So let's go weigh myself now. Y'all gonna have to excuse this hole in my sock. Let's see how much I weigh. Uh-oh, y'all. What did I say? Yeah, y'all, I don't know why it's saying 162. I was just 163 this morning. Let me weigh myself one more time just to confirm. Yeah, guys, so I'm definitely at 162. I was just all the way up to 166 last week when I barely was recording. But
It looked like I lost weight. And I do feel like I did today because all I had today literally was a bowl of oatmeal, a bagel, and that's it. I just ate some rice and some ground turkey, a little ground turkey patty. But that one little situation, y'all, just made my appetite. It was about to fly out the window, but it didn't. I didn't take any impediment today, and I didn't take any impediment yesterday. I don't think I'm going to take any impediment today. I don't know. Well, I'm going to see how I feel in a little bit, in the next hour. But right now, I just gargled with some clove and water. You put some clove and some water and swish it around on your tooth that's in pain. And it should, like, calm the nerve a little bit. And it helped. So if anybody is suffering from a toothache, go get you some seasoning. It's called clove. And get you some warm water. Sprinkle some of that clove inside the water. Swish it around on your tooth. It has to taste like black licorice. That's what it tastes like to me. But you swish it around on your cheek. I mean, on your tooth. Whatever tooth is bothering you. And you spit until, you know, it's going to start feeling like a numb sensation. And the tooth should start to die down. But y'all, me trying to gain weight with two teeth that are literally exposed, the nerves are exposed, this has been really crazy. Because, like, I have really good teeth in up back here. But because those two teeth are so exposed and open, it's like I can't wait to get these two teeth pulled out and hopefully get my implant on this side of my mouth. But anyway, y'all, my face is still looking chunky. So that's a good sign. And I'm definitely in the 160s. Not in the 140s. Not in the 150s. It's still in the 160s. So we just got to bring that 162 back up to like 160. I don't want to get out of the 160s, y'all. So just say a little prayer for your girl. And I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Hey, guys. What's up? It is March 26th, Tuesday, and I had a toothache all day, y'all, all day. I ate a bagel this morning. Well, first I had some oatmeal, then I ate a bagel. I just woke up. It's 12 something in the morning, in the evening. About to be 1 o'clock in the morning. But I had to go take care of that business at motor vehicle. On my way to motor vehicle, I ate some oatmeal, which I think the oatmeal might have been too sweet. It was strawberries and cream. My tooth started acting a little funny. When I came home, I had toasted me a blueberry bagel. And I ate that on my way to work. Now, my mouth been hurting ever since I ate that bagel, which was like 12 this past afternoon. A little bit before 12, it was like around 11:30 in the morning. Monday morning. So I came home after work and I ate me some rice, a little ground turkey patty. I rinsed my mouth out with some cloves and water with the Listerine. But this time, y'all, nothing I'm doing is working. So say a prayer for your girl. I'm going to try to get this video out by this week so y'all can be up to date on my progress with my weight gain journey and my teeth journey. Because with the way my teeth have been bothering me lately, I'm praying I don't go back into the 150s. But right now, I think I was at 162 or 163 or something like that. And I just was trying to get into the 170s, but the way these two teeth are acting up right now, it's just, I don't know how I'm going to do it. Like I said, when I came home, I had some rice and a little brown turkey patty. And I think I made some noodles or something like that. I just know I didn't get all my calories today. And I didn't even make me a smoothie or anything, which I might have to do that right quick. But the smoothie not going to have no walnuts and almonds in it right now. It's just going to be banana, almond milk, and honey. I don't know what to do, y'all. I'm just literally, like, been in pain all day. Just trying to, like, smile through the pain. Not really, like, telling nobody that I'm in excruciating pain. I was going to not go to work today because I had some business I had to take care of. But if I don't go to work, everything is just all thrown off at my job. So I feel like I have to go to work, like, even when I'm in pain. But, like, before when I had a toothache, it stopped. But this time, it's just, like, I feel like somebody just been punching me in this right cheek, wait, in my left cheek all day. After I eat that bagel. So I appreciate you guys watching my videos, liking my videos, because I really don't tell people what's going on with me. Because sometimes people that you think should care the most, everybody going through their own stuff in 2019. So nowadays, no matter how much of a helpful person you've been to them in their life, people don't care nowadays. So that's why I just be to myself, and I've always bottled up what's wrong with me, because I'm always listening to what's wrong with other people. So I appreciate you guys listening to me. Even if it's 5 people, 10 people that view my video, I just want to be able to just go through my journey with you guys, and maybe teach someone else along the line who might be being discouraged or might not be motivated or inspired to do whatever they're trying to do. Like, I'm still trying to learn this YouTube thing, but I'm learning as the days go by, and I'm not going to bother nobody with showing me anything. They have classes, they have all kinds of ways to learn how to YouTube. So, but I'm going all over the place, but I do appreciate you guys watching my videos. They're going to be more consistent and more juicy once I get this dental work done, because I can't be in my right mind if I got a mild, not even mild, from a scale of 1 to 10, it's about a 7, and it's been a 7 all day. And for some reason I can't find my, cause now my ear is making my ear hurt, and I can't sleep when I'm like this. So pray for a sister, y'all. And, I'm gonna holler at y'all later. I'm gonna probably end this, vlog or whatever here. Pray for a sister, y'all. I'm still waiting for the dentist to call me and let me know if they approve my, these 2 teeth in the back to be extracted, which I'm pretty sure they should, approve them. Oh my God, I won't wish this pain on anybody, y'all. I just wanted to get up here and talk to y'all right quick, because it's like 12 something in the morning, and I literally tried to like sleep this pain away. Woke up and it's still here. So I'm going to try to find something to take, like some pills or some pain medicine. I don't really like to take pain medicine. I always try to do the natural remedy first, but it's just not working. And I really want to keep my gains. I don't want them to drop back into the 150s. But anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed this vlog. If you're still watching this far, make sure you smash the like button. Make sure you subscribe if you're new to my channel. And make sure you stay humble, stay blessed, and stay woke. And I love y'all for watching.